G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and in this video I'm going to start a series of videos. We're going to take you through the process of developing the plan and the elevations for a roof. So in this first video I'm just going to do a very simple roof and we'll go through the rules, and then in the next few videos we'll get a little bit more complicated roofs going. So the first thing we need to look at are the rules. Now the reason why you would do this is before you actually build a roof, you want to know where the hips go and where the ridges go mainly, and the valleys on more complicated roofs. So this is just a quick way of drawing up the plans to get and work out where they actually go and which ones will be broken hips and that sort of thing. So a couple of the rules to start with. So all angles formed by external wall plates must be bisected. Okay, so the angle must cut the corner in half. Rule 2, only one member is drawn from any one corner. Rule 3, hips are formed where the plates form an external corner. And rule 4, valleys are created where an internal corner is formed by two plates. And we'll see that in a couple of videos' time. Rule 5, rafters are always set at 90 degrees to the plates. And rule 6, a ridge will always be level and parallel to the external wall plates. Okay, so there's the rules. Now let's put them into play. So the first thing we should do is go around our wall plates or our shape and bisect all our corners. So draw these dotted lines in and bisect the corners. So 90 degree corner, this angle is going to be 45. Okay, and the second rule, one member from each corner. So yeah, one there, one there, one there, one there. Hips are formed by where the plates form an external corner. So this will be a hip up to here and a hip down to here. So let's draw the hips in. So I'll darken the hips in and I'll get rid of my development lines. So I now have a hip coming up from each corner, one member from each corner, till they meet in the center. Okay, we don't need to worry about rafters. We don't have any valleys in this particular one. So our ridge is always level, which is not so important at the moment, but it's also parallel to our external walls. So if we come off our external walls parallel to where these two points meet in the middle, that will be the position of our ridge. Okay, so with this very simple hip roof, I've got position of my four hips and the position of my ridge. So that's what it looks like on plan. Now let's have a look at what the elevation's going to look like. So first thing I need to do is all the major points on my plan I'm going to develop up onto my baseline. So I've drawn in this baseline. I'm just picking those major points, not many on this roof. Okay, so I'm going to pick a roof pitch, so let's say 30 degrees. So this corner starts at my roof line, at my say fascia line, and it starts here. And it goes up at whatever my roof pitch angle is till it hits the ridge, which will be where that line is. So let's go 30 degrees up to where it hits the ridge. Now, our ridges are always level, so we can draw in our ridge, and it goes from this line across to this line, and then this side is just going to come back down to our baseline, and there we have our shape of our side elevation for this roof. Alright, now we can do our end elevation. So develop our lines across sideways, 30 degrees again. We're going to come up from our baseline up to where our ridge would be, and then quite simply back down. So there we go, we've got the elevation, the end elevation for our roof. So there you go, that's the process of developing the position of our hips and ridges and valleys when we have a valley, and developing the elevations for our roofs.